In part one of our lesson on graphs of sine and cosine, you're going to learn about periodic functions. A quick description of a periodic function is that it is a function that repeats itself over and over again. So we're going to let P stand for the period, which is the length of time for one cycle of the graph, which is the piece of the graph that repeats itself, one cycle. We'll let n stand for an integer. Then to say that f of x is periodic means that f of the quantity x plus n times p has to equal f of x. Now, don't be put off by this quantity here. Let's think about what this means. N, we know, is an integer, so that could be the whole numbers and their opposites, so negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, etc. We know that P is the length of a period. So all this is saying is that the y value that I have at any given x value is going to be the same y value I get if I start at that x value and go over by any number of full periods. So let's take a look at this next example to help you understand this better. Consider the graph of f of x here, which gives the height of an object in feet over time in seconds. And the first thing we're asked to do is to find the period of f of x. Now let's remember this definition. We know the period is the length of time for one cycle. Now if we look at the graph, some students will mistakenly think that the period of the graph is 6 seconds because that's where the first cycle ends. But in this case, for this graph, you have to notice that the graph didn't begin at zero. So the graph began at x equals 2 and ends at x equals 6 for that first cycle. So to find the period, we're going to do the ending value, which is 6, minus the beginning value, which is 2. So we get that the period is going to be 4 seconds. So that's the time from beginning to end. And you can see that that would be the same had we used the second cycle, because the second cycle ends at 10 and begins at 6. 10 minus 6 is also 4. So you can see that no matter which cycle we would choose, we're going to get that the period is 4. If we choose the last one, 14 minus 10 is also 4. Next, we're being asked to evaluate each function value. So f of 3, if we go on the graph here, we know that tells us to go to an x value of 3, which is here. And we have to look at the y value there, which would be right up here. So we know that f of 3 is equal to 5. Now next, let's notice what happens. I'm purposely writing these in this form, the x plus np form. We've said that our period is 4 seconds. So if we start at t is equal to 3 and we go over by one full period, so this is like the x plus n times p, where n is equal to 1, we see we would have 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. If we look on the graph at f of 7, we come over here to 7, we go up on the graph and we see that the y value is also equal to 5. So f of 7 was equal to f of 3 because the distance from 3 to 7 was 1 period. And that's what this is saying. If I start at 3 and I go over by any number of periods, which in this case was 1 period, then I'm going to get the same y value as I did at 3. Let's look at this next one. We have f of 3 plus 2 times 4. So again, this is our x plus any number of periods. That's what's going on there. This is f of 3 plus 8 is 11. Now if we go on the graph and look at 11, we see the y value there is also 5. So we can extrapolate then that if we're at any x value that is an integer multiple away from x equals 3, then we know that the y value there is just going to equal f of 3, which is 5. So that's using the power of the periodic function. So if we take a look back now at the examples we did, this first one where we did f of 3 plus 1 times the period, which is 4, we see that 3 plus a period is 7, which means if we start here, we've gone over by 3 plus 1 times the period, and the y value there is going to be the same, 5. If we look at this one, we started at x equals 3 and went over by 2 periods, which is a distance of 8. So if we start at 3 and go over by 8, we ended up at 11, and we can see on the graph that it has the same y value. But physically what's happening is if we're starting at 3, of course the y value is 5, but we're talking about x equaling 3. If we go over by 2 periods, so this would be 3 plus 2 times 4, we're at f of 11, and f of 11 is also 5, which equals f of 7, which equals f of 3. So all of these are going to equal f of 3, which we know is 5, and that's how periodic functions work. In this next example, we're going to let f of x equal the set that is the days of the week with f of 1 equaling Sunday. So let's first just make a list of our domain and range elements. We know when x is equal to 1, f of x is going to be Sunday. So then that means when x is 2, f of 2 is equal to Monday. When x is 3, f of 3 is equal to Tuesday. F of 4 is equal to Wednesday. F of 5 is equal to Thursday. F of 6 will be Friday, and f of 7 is equal to Saturday. So here's our entire range. There's no other possibilities for the days of the week. And now this first question asks, what is the period of f of x? Well, we know that if we continued on here, we know that if x was 8, that f of 8 is going to equal Sunday, To find our period, we take the end of the cycle and subtract away the beginning of the cycle. 8 minus 1 is equal to 7. So we know that the period of our f of x is 7 days. And we knew this from the beginning. We know there are 7 days in a week. Next, we're being asked to evaluate f of 5. So that's easy enough to see. F of 5 is going to equal Thursday. Next, we're asked to evaluate f of 26. Now, we could go through in this manner and write down 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, all the way up to 26, but you can see that that would get pretty tedious very quickly. So what we want to use now is the power of the periodic function. We know that the period is 7 days, so if we can write this 26 in terms of an integer multiple of periods plus a starting point, then we'll know what day of the week it's going to be. So this is going to equal f of, well, we know 26, the nearest multiple of 7 would be 21. So we know it's going to be plus 3 times 7, which of course is 21. So to get from 21 to 26, we know that we need to add 5. Now, using the power of the periodic function, we know that we can say that f of x plus any number of periods is going to equal f of x. So that means f of 26, which is equal to f of 5 plus 3 times 7, has to equal f of 5, which we already know what f of 5 is. It's Thursday. Okay, so pause the video and try this next example on your own, and then restart the video when you're ready to check. So for f of 58, we want to find the integer multiple of 7 that's nearest it. We know that 8 times 7 is 56. So we're going to take 8 times 7. And then we'll need to add 2 more, because 2 plus 56 is equal to 58. Then we know, again, using the power of the periodic function, this is our f of x plus n times p. We know that's going to have to equal f of x. So then f of 58 is going to have to equal f of 2. And f of 2, we know, is Monday. So that saves us from having to write out all 58 pieces of the domain and figuring out what each range element is to get there. We use the power of the periodic function to simplify greatly what we have to do.